What's up, beautiful people? It's Brianna Lillian, and it's been like 10 months, kind of, since I made a video, so that's almost a year. Damn, I can't believe I stopped. I mean, I just kind of, life just kind of got me busy. I cared too much about the view count. I didn't feel like anybody was watching. I'm just kind of making this video to kind of 2015 recap, like, what have I been doing? Where have I been? What has my past year looked like? And yeah, the last video I made was my ear talk Q&A, and then damn, I just haven't sat down and made a video in a while. And I mean, a lot has happened this past year. I mean, job wise I started the year with one job that I've had for almost 2 years, which is Target. And then I got another job at Great Clips. Didn't end up working out. And then I was at Target for a while. And I moved to Alaska. I'll explain later on in this video. I moved to Alaska, got a job at Sally Beauty Supply, which was one of the dopest jobs I've ever fucking had. It was super chill, met some really cool people there. And then I moved back to California, and then I got a job at Amazon, which I didn't really like. So I kind of just stopped going. And right now I'm working at Styles for Less, and also a hair salon, so I guess I am still trying to be a stylist, not really sure what I'm gonna do. But this year is almost over, and I'm already on my fifth job, which is just insane to me. I mean, through a lot of different things, you know, trying out different things, seeing what I like best. And so far I've come to realize that, you know, I like retail. I like working with people. I like being a stylist sometimes. I mean, I just think I need to like fix my skills a little bit and I'll be fully confident, but I'm not fully there right now. And I'm not really sure what career I want to follow, honestly. I've never been so unsure of something in my life. I'm kind of just taking it day by day, and I'm learning new stuff about me, and you know, I'm gonna go to college soon again. Who knows where that might take me? I mean, right now I'm kind of just chilling and trying to figure myself out. Yes, you heard that right. I was in Alaska. Wouldn't you like what happened here? As if you lost something you love. Look at pictures of the moonlight. Try to pick out a face. For the summer. And mainly, I wanted to experience life outside of California. Now, I'm 22. I've been in California my entire life. I had an opportunity to move to Alaska with somebody who I hold so close to my heart. And it was one of the coolest fucking experiences I've ever been through. I mean, I lived in a different state. I lived on my own. I didn't live with my parents. It was hard because, you know, I didn't have my family around, and it made me realize, you know, how close to my family and how much I need my family in my life, and I can never be apart from them for that long ever again. And, you know, I didn't really have that many friends out there. I was just with that one person, which wasn't bad, you know, I mean, those 3 months in Alaska, it was a really cool experience. I mean, I lived in a different state. I got on my first airplane. On an airplane till that time, and it was just, it's something I'll never forget. And those are some memories that I will hold so close to my heart. And then towards the end of like October, decided to move back to California for, you know, personal reasons. And me and that person that I lived with, we took a road trip. Nowhere to go and no place to come. From Alaska, through Canada, through Washington, through Oregon, through Northern California, back home. I've never fucking driven that long in my life, and it was just the coolest fucking thing ever. I mean, I seen a bunch of random animals on the side. I met some really cool people. I drove through like some hectic ass weather, and it was just an experience that I felt like I needed to have. And it was an experience that I would never fucking forget, because it was one of the coolest things I've ever done. I've never felt so free. Peter Pan, that's what they call me. I promise that you'll never be lonely. Peter Pan, that's what they call me. I promise that you'll never be lonely. from that time, from Alaska back home, I realized so much about myself. I realized that, you know, I love being on an airplane. I really fucking liked it. It was one of the most beautiful things you can ever experience, especially because I got the window seat. It's so surreal. In a road trip, I realized that there's a lot of places I want to go. There's a lot of things I want to do. There's a lot of things I want to see. You know, everybody says that you know, they want to travel, they want to go places, they want to do things they've never done before, but the airplane ride, the Alaska, the road trip, all of it just made me open my eyes, and it made me realize, you know, there's so much I haven't seen, and there's so much I want to do. And, you know, I want to go to New York someday. I've always had that dream in my head, but I want to make that a reality. And there's just so many things that I wish to see, and I'm so young, and it was kind of like a little wake-up call, like, hey, your life isn't over. You know, there's so much you need to do before you get old, before you get married, before you have a baby, before you die. You know, there's just so much. So between Alaska and between the last time I made a video and that entire year, I went from one really fucking toxic relationship, which thankfully ended because it just did, but it made me realize a lot about relationships and friendships. You know, if something is toxic, you don't need to deal with it. No matter how much you love or care or respect that person, you need to love, care, and respect yourself so much more, because that toxic, it does damage you. As much as you think in your head, no, I'm fine, nothing can ever affect me, it does. And I mean, I wish I realized that a lot sooner, because that's almost 2 years that I was in something super toxic that I should have stayed away from. But I went from something super toxic to something super healthy. But that second relationship, it was rushed, and you know, that's not good for us. And I took a lot of anger, resentment, insecurities, and all that stuff from that girl, from, you know, to the next girl, and I feel so bad about that. And maybe I did ruin the relationship because of that, but I learned so much relationship-wise. You know, I learned that I don't deserve what I went through. I don't deserve to be treated like that, and I would never allow myself to be treated like that again. I learned a lot about the person I am, and you know, it opened my eyes a lot, because there's a lot about me that I need to work on. You know, I thought I was fine. I thought, you know, I could handle it, but nobody can. I mean, that's really a hard situation to go through. And, you know, to the girl that I lived in Alaska with and I spent my entire summer with, I can't even apologize enough for how I acted. I mean, there's really no excuses for it, but I learned a lot. I learned a lot from both relationships, and I'm glad they happened, because now I know what I expect in a partner, and I know what I expect from myself. I know that I need to learn how to be a certain type of girlfriend, and I learned that I need to be a certain type of person. And overall, everybody just taught me that I need to learn to love myself. I mean, I say it 100 times, you know, yeah, I love myself, whatever, blah, blah, blah. But it doesn't really mean anything if you don't believe in it. I went through, you know, a few piercings. I got a few more tattoos. Almost done with half a sleeve. Still have some work to go. But, I mean, yeah, 2016, I hope it brings more tattoos, more modifications. You know, I want my dermal back. I want my nose piercing again. So between those 5 jobs, 2 relationships, living in 2 different states, experiencing a lot, I mean, this year has just taught me more than any year has ever taught me. It taught me about myself, relationships, friendships, family, everything. You know, I realized what I'm worth, and I realized that friendships require effort. And I grew up, you know, thinking, oh, friendships aren't real, friends don't exist, because of the way my family taught me. But they are real, and friendships are a big part in who you are as a person, because friendships, they can change you a lot in a good way or in a bad way, you know. So I learned to, you know, surround myself with good people, not be so closed off. I learned to open up a little bit more than, you know, I've ever had in my life. And I'm back home. I kind of feel like I'm starting over, you know, like I got a whole fresh start to life. And so overall, 2015 has been the craziest fucking year of my life. It's been so up and down, biggest roller coasters, and I couldn't be any more happier. I mean, I'm not fully happy with how my life is, but I am now taking the steps to get it to where I want to be. And you know, I learned a lot about the person I was and the person I want to be and the person I am. There's a lot of things that I guess said or did that I'm not really too happy with, you know? And so I think this whole new year, I want it to be a good year. I want good memories. Overall, that's what I want. I want good memories. I want good people surrounding me. I want my family. I want good vibes, you know, positive energy. I love all that stuff. All that stuff drives me and I love it so much. I changed a lot, thankfully, because of a certain person in my life that I spent the entire summer with. You know, she opened my eyes a lot, and even though we're not talking anymore, I'm so thankful for those life lessons that she's given me, because I think I am a better person because of her. And now I'm gonna be a better person because of me. I need to do this for me. I can't keep jumping from relationship to relationship. And you know, I need to focus on me. I need to focus on where I wanna be, who I wanna be, how I wanna be. This upcoming year, it's gonna be all about me. You know, I mean, not fully, but a majority of it, I have to put myself first. That's something I've never done. You know, I love people. I love making other people happy. But at the end of the day, I need to do that for myself as well. You know, I'm not gonna change. I'm not gonna, you know, shut everybody out and just worry about me. But I think I'm gonna start worrying about me a little bit more. Well, that's pretty much it for this video. I kind of just want to do a little 2015 recap. Where have I been? Where will I be going? And where I'm at now. I hope you guys like this video. I mean, it's just a little random video that I want to be back on YouTube. You know, I really do. I want to make videos again. This isn't going to be the last. I know I always say, oh, I'm going to make a video, and then the views, because they're not as where I want them to be, they're kind of like disappointing, but I don't care anymore. You know, I think I lost myself because of the girl I was with the beginning of the year. I lost a lot of myself in that, and I'm now beginning to find myself again, and I love making YouTube videos. I mean, I love the process of, you know, sitting here with the camera, talking to you guys, and then editing it, posting it, seeing the positive feedback. I like it, even if it's just like one or two comments, dude. I love it so much. So this year has been very educational to me. Lost myself, lost a few people, gained a few people, starting to find myself again. I don't think it's really about finding yourself though. I think honestly it's all about creating yourself, and I want to create somebody that the old me would be proud of. I want to create somebody that the future me would be proud of. I want to be somebody that I'm happy with. So after this video, I'm going to record a video for 2016. It's going to be kind of like, it's gonna be a private video till the end of 2016, because I wanna talk and make a video, and I wanna tell myself, you know, like, hey, this is where you are, and in a year from now, this is where you should be or where you wanna be. And so that video is gonna be on private till the end of the year. So I mean, if you guys are with me that long, you guys will probably see it. So I guess that's it for this video. I hope you guys liked it. I hope you guys liked the little pictures, the little videos. I hope it's not too long. If it is, I'm sorry. If you stayed through the whole video, comment down below, yellow elephant. I mean, I don't know, something random, just so I know you guys watch full videos and not just stop it halfway through. I don't know, but that's it for this video. Comment down below what kind of videos you guys wanna see. Maybe I'll do a few. I mean, I have a whole list of videos I wanna do, and I'm actually gonna do them, because that's what I want to do. And yeah, so that's it for this video, guys. I mean, thumbs up, please, if you guys liked it. Comment down below, how was your 2015? What is the most exciting thing you've done this year? For me, it was probably the road trip. I mean, that was pretty dope. And then, you know, comment down below also, what is 2016 gonna mean to you? What is the one thing you wish to accomplish? So you do subscribe so you are notified when I do make videos. I'm starting to be on Instagram more again. You know, I went kind of MIA for a while. I needed to clear my head, make sure my heart was okay. As gay as that sounds, I mean, yeah. Say hi, let's be friends. All my social media links will be down below. The one place you can mainly find me is Snapchat. I mean, sometimes Instagram. Snapchat's really my main like go-to. So all my links will be down below, and yeah. That's it for this video. I hope to see your comments soon. I will be commenting back, and I'll see you guys next video. Hopefully it's soon, but I hope you guys are doing good. I hope this year wasn't too bad for you. I hope this year was good for you, and I hope 2016 will be wonderful for you, because you're beautiful and you're amazing, and don't ever let anybody treat you like you're worthless. So yeah, stop the hate, spread the love, and smile, because you are beautiful.
you love me.